Today we going to see some reason why business fails. Subscribe the channel and leave a comment if you have any doubt regarding any business, comment below. So the number 7 is lack of resources. In the short run, a lack of resources may actually improve performance as the business stretches to do more for less. Lean and hungry may lead to better performance. When employees realize that their livelihoods and futures depend upon their performance, extra effort may be the result. At some point, the lack of resources may cause an increasing drag on business performance. A certain weariness and fatigue from the constant stress of cash-strapped businesses operating on marginal resources will weaken the performance of even the most dedicated staff. When the lack of resources becomes acute, the business is in serious risk of failure. Most often this happens when there aren't enough cash resources, but it can also occur when the human resources aren't adequate, or there's not enough inventory. Many otherwise successful businesses have tanked as a result of not enough human resources or cash flow problems. The most common reasons small businesses fail include a lack of capital or funding, retaining an inadequate management team, a faulty infrastructure or business model, and unsuccessful marketing initiatives. The sixth reason is outdated technology. Upgrades in either form, physical or digital, generally come with a variety of improvements in both usability and functionality. This change can be especially true with version or hardware upgrades, where new features are introduced or old functions are improved considerably to boost performance. If and when this change happens and you're still using outdated tech, it immediately does a number on your business performance and competitive level. With each new system or device, it becomes increasingly more difficult to compete in the market, more so if your rivals are using the new systems. It also significantly limits your organization and team's ability to respond to recent changes in the market. If a product or system is lacking a feature that new tech has, that's one less thing you can take advantage of in the context of operations. The negative implications of outdated tech are even more exacerbated when they involve customer experience and usability. Customers expect a streamlined and convenient user interface when using systems and technology, and that applies to your employees as well. Outdated technologies can result in subpar experiences, which means your business is judged on its inability to keep up. Finally, there's the more technical nature of utilizing outdated tech, which can have a decidedly damaging influence. This short combing includes potential scenarios such as data loss, increased vulnerability to cyber attacks, lack of data or connection security, poor performance and even improper operations. All of these issues can introduce a crippling effect on your personnel and teams, who find their time and efforts derailed by ineffective or broken solutions. It's also important to remember that while the most common forms of devices are computers, tablets, mobile tools, IoT equipment and sensors, servers and the like, there are outlying devices that should be regularly updated too. The fifth reason is wrong location. When trying to predict the success of a business, location is one of the most important factors. Even though it doesn't seem like a very important one, you should carefully consider the location when choosing your business space. Let's go through the ways location affects the success of your business and how to choose the perfect one for you. The most important: businesses that are difficult to go to will often lose their customers. That's why you need to choose a location that will make it suitable for your customers' needs. To determine that, be sure to understand who your target customers are and how they will come to your place. Another important thing to consider is how new customers will find out about you. Again, you need to consider your target customers and choose the location that will help them find you. When running a successful business, you need to make sure that the goods you need to arrive on time. So, definitely, location affects the success of your business when it comes to getting supplies. If you are able to get your goods easily and on time, your customers will be happy to shop at your place. Since location is a very important factor for your business, you need to think carefully when trying to find it. Here are the main steps in choosing the perfect location for a successful business. Think about your needs, do research on population demographics, look for the competition, and other businesses. Do some research about the businesses in the area. Are there any that could potentially become your competition? Move your business safely. The fourth reason is lack of customers. When you lose customers, you lose sales. And lost sales equals, I guessed it, a loss of profits. Depending on the severity of your customer loss, the number of profits you lose as a result could have a lasting impact on the financial health of your business. Don't let bad customer service to break your business. It's obvious that bad customer service can impact your business, but it doesn't have to break you down. Ensure that your employees are providing great customer service, and resolve any issues that come up as quickly as possible, and you'll improve your reputation in no time. Also, hiring bad employees, one of the reason business fails. Bad employees tend to be absent more often. This either slows down your team's work, or requires expensive temps. Less revenue weak performers will generate significantly less revenue than their motivated peers. Each one of your team is an ambassador that represents your business. The third reason is choosing wrong platform. Don't waste time posting on the wrong platform for your business, as all businesses know, content counts. The kind of content you create, like website pages, blog posts, video content, and social media messages, can be a key part of how you market yourself to clients and customers. However, as many companies know, there are a lot of places on which to create or post content, and this leads to a lot of confusion surroundings where to publish, when, and why. Using too many platforms can create unnecessary complications, particularly when you're still attempting to develop a marketing strategy that resonates. It's easy to find right platform. Identify your audience. The first step is to identify who your audience. Define your goals. Once you know your audience, you need to define goals for that audience. Find your audience. The second reason is lack of passion. They just like the idea of success. Without having some sort of passion driving you, you will not survive as an entrepreneur, because the grind of building a business will take a toll on you emotionally, mentally, and physically. This can be very tough to overcome without having a purpose or passion driving you forward. Once you've identified your passion, spend some time working to develop it. Set specific goals. Find accountability. Take breaks. Reevaluate your progress. Keep developing your passion. Once you've reached some level of success with your passion, most likely your dream career, it's time to enjoy it, but never be lax about it. Avoid becoming complacent by continuing to grow. Take a class or attend a seminar to learn the latest developments in your field. Conferences are great for networking with others who are pursuing their own similar passions. Connecting with these people can provide you new information and perhaps a renewed passion in what you're doing. And the number one reason why business fails is lack of knowledge. Yes, business knowledge is an important strategic asset. It is a sum of skills, experiences, capabilities, and expert insight, which you collectively create and rely on in your business. As a shared resource, knowledge shapes and affects all the activities in and around your business. Strategies to improve your business knowledge. Find a mentor and improve your business knowledge immediately. One way to get started in running your own business is by finding an expert mentor who can show you the best methods to getting started. Look for influential business owners in your community and seek as much information as you can from them. Their business knowledge can help you a lot. If you want to open your own restaurant, try working in a kitchen first. Opening your own retail store could be a better idea if you have worked in sales at some point. If you're dreaming of running your own car wash, try your hand at helping out an operator before you take the plunge with your own cash investment. And fifth is, never get advice from average people. Let's take example, you are now 15 years old. You want to become a pilot in your 20s. You know two peoples, one become pilot, and another said, I wish to become pilot. But I couldn't. From whom you get your advice, comment below. Subscribe the channel. Meet you in next video.